Hello, everyone. Welcome to my first Let's Play ever. This is Dark Souls, a game that I played many, many hours of. On PC alone, I have 250. I got the platinum on PlayStation, so I haven't played this game. I haven't played it in a while, though, so I'm gonna be pretty rusty. I watched a lot of Let's Plays with, Vadi and mostly Epic Name Bro. So I do love all the lore that they tell me. So I'm gonna try to talk about some of that stuff, but just be aware that when I do see that stuff, it's probably inspired by or probably got that information from other people. So let's jump right in. The character I want to make on this one is a not load. It's gonna be a dexterity and intelligence character, I think. It's gonna be using pyromancy, mostly just power within, not much else. We're gonna use the intelligence to up our magic crystal weapon. Basically, it's gonna be just like a boss killer. But obviously, we got a ways to go before we do that. So, let's jump in. Let's name our character. Just name him Toss, I guess, for now. Oops. Come on. It's always a little finicky between the controller and the keyboard, but this is the only time it's ever really like this. So, toss, enter, done. Okay. We made it. Male class. I want. In the beginning of the game, you want vitality, and it's gonna be eventually dexterity, so those are the two I'm looking for. Thief is probably the good one. Problem is obviously low vitality, but we can pump that up. The thing I like about Thief, it's got attunement out the door. It keeps the strength down, which I want. Endurance is okay, but yeah, let's go Thief. Okay, so gift. Okay, the go-to is always Master Key. I think we're gonna do Master Key. Just to get through Blighttown, maybe. I haven't decided if I actually want to use it, but I probably will. Let's do Slim, a bit easier to see your character, I think. Face doesn't matter, you never see your character. The only thing is hair that matters, and even that is not so bad. So, let's do. Just get moving here. Let's do. I don't know. Curly? Yeah, sure, why not? Looks good. Color? Let's do blue. No. Let's make him old. Alright. I think we're good. Okay, we're gonna start this and we're going to watch the first cutscene. So enjoy.
In the age of ancients, the world was unformed, shrouded by fog. A land of gray crags, arch trees, and everlasting dragons. But then there was fire, and with fire came disparity, heat and cold, life and death, and of course, light and dark. Then from the dark, they came
Humans.
and found the souls of lords within the flame. Nito, the first of the dead. The Witch of Izalith and her Daughters of Chaos. Gwyn, the Lord of Sunlight, and his faithful knights. And the furtive pygmy, so easily forgotten. With the strength of lords, they challenged the dragons. Gods, mighty gods, wield a hand best unskilled slayer. Witches weaved great firestorms. Nito unleashed a miasma of death and disease. And Seath the Scaleless betrayed his own, and the dragons were no more. Soon the flames will fade, and only dark will remain. Even now, there are only embers, and man sees not light, but only endless nights. And amongst the living are seen carriers of the accursed dark side.
Cool.
Yes, indeed. The dark sign brands the undead. And in this land, the undead are corralled and led to the north. Where they are locked away to await the end of the world. This is your fate.
All right, well, there's a lot to unpack in that first cutscene. Sets it all up really well. I love all the character, or all the gods who grab the souls. The Furtive Pygmy being the humans, I believe. Gwyn grabbing the One of Flame. It's really cool. Here, of course, we see the Stray Demon, which I totally missed the first couple times here. I didn't even know he's there until I watched the playthrough of EMB. Trying to relearn the controls has been a long time. So, my game is a little framey. I'm playing this on the laptop right now. So, you know, excuse the bit of framiness here. Alright, first bonfire lit. So this is a cool thing that I'm sure you see on every playthrough, but you can see the first boss right up there. See his little face there. Of course, the Asylum Demon. This is the first game I've ever played that's really done this well, where they introduce the first boss and you just start whacking on him. You don't even know the controls, you have no idea what you're doing. And it just teaches you that, you know, it's okay to run away. thought that was so smart every game. You can kill him, but, you know, it's not worth it at all. So, the game, right out the bat, teaches you level design and teaches you its, you know, mechanics by just the elements of the level and the problems you have to face and overcome. So, kind of getting you to think outside the box already. The level design in this game is so impressive. So we get our first shield here. See if I can even remember how to equip things. Seems like I do. Alright, so got my first shield. I think I remember how to block. Come up here, kill our first guy. And get the bandit's knife. Cool. Alright, I remember how to backstab. That's a good sign. Oh, jeez. Can you equip? Yeah, you can equip. So let's do. See if I can. Got it. Cool. Alright. So, got the new weapon. Much better. The knife is actually a pretty cool weapon with this build I'm going to do. The goal of the build is to put a lot of damage on your weapon, and it's a set amount, so it's like 20. Or 30 or something, and with dexterity you have the fastest weapons, so that 20 or 30 just hits the monster over and over again. So this is completely built for just super fast weapons. Cool little trap up there. You can kind of see the boulder before you go up. We unlock the shortcut, which we'll definitely need for when we come back here. And rest at the bonfire for just for funsies. So come on up, and we'll meet our friend, Oscar.
Oh, you. You're no Hollow. Thank goodness. I'm done for, I'm afraid. I'll die soon, then lose my sanity. I wish to ask something of you. You and I, we're both undead. Hear me out, will you?
Generally, you want to say yes to everything in this game.
Regrettably, I have failed in my mission, but perhaps you can keep the torch lit.
Sure.
There is an old saying in my family. Thou who art undead art chosen, and thine exodus from the undead asylum maketh pilgrimage to the land of ancient lords. When thou ringeth the bell of awakening, the fate of the undead thou shalt know. Well, now you know, and I can die with hope in my heart. Oh, one more thing. Here, take this. An Estus flask. An undead favorite.
Oscar is.
Oh, and this.
Thank you.
Now I must bid farewell. I would hate to harm you after death. So go now. And thank you.
Oscar is a really cool character. There's no access to get out of this room. The only way is through that hole. He was on the roof. It's implied he's the guy who threw down the body in the cage to give you the key to get out of there. He says that the prophecy, or the saying rather, of his family is the one who escapes the asylum and brings balance to the force, right? Implying it's you. Doesn't necessarily have to be you. There's a lot of theories that it's not you. In fact, another character in the game that we're going to meet, even maybe Oscar himself, but we'll see on that. Okay, so come around the corner here. Right there is your magic spells. If you were a magic user, you can get it right there. And practice my backstabs. Seems like I still got it. Alright. Can I parry? I cannot parry yet. I'm not that good. I can two-hand my knife. Looks a little weird. Alright, let's get that rid of that. Dodge this guy. Whoop. The number one thing people have trouble with on backstabs is they try to backstab with their shield up, and it will not let you do that if that's the case. You have to drop your shield completely, leave your guard down for X amount of time before it will let you actually commit the backstab. So this guy, you actually don't have to fight this guy. I don't know. That's not very nice. See if we can parry him after. Maybe a heal. Alright, let's try. Can I do it? I can! always a great feeling. Okay. Let's go and fight the first boss. Again, another tutorial section right here. There's a big monster below you. Let's learn how to drop on him. Cool. This boss is going to be a little tough with the knife, actually, now that I think about it. Ooh. Not good for being rusty. Alright, let's see what we can do here. Should we lock onto it? Yeah, let's lock onto it. Alright, so we're just gonna try to best to dodge him and just poke him. Just poke him. Really bad. Ugh. God. Alright, let's mess this up. Get Sunny D. Oops. Ah, man. Come on, I can do this. I dodged something. And dodge! Alright, I've killed the first boss. This is not a good sign. Cool. Okay, let's look at the items we got. How do I look at items? Oscar gave us this, I think? Even if undead were to escape from the cell, passage to the outside world would not be easily gained. There's no way off this thing. Key to the inner door of the undead asylum main hall. Pretty interesting. Alright, let's start the game. So, over here, the one thing I've never done, actually, I don't think there's anything down here, right? No. There's some souls up here that are hidden. You might fall off the path. Don't fall off the path. Got it. Over here, I've actually haven't seen this until, like, the last time I played this game. I never have seen this thing over here. Thought they talked to you. Guess not. Alright. Well, let's go up. I think they asked for something shiny, something smooth, or something like that.
Only in the ancient legends, it is stated that one day an undead shall be chosen. To leave the undead asylum in pilgrimage to the land of the ancient lords. Lordran.
Lordran. Really cool. There's a guy on Reddit, forgot his name, who made a picture of Lordran, just a map of how all the inner workings go together. He sold it at PAX this year. I live in Boston, so at PAX East he was selling it. It's a really cool poster. I didn't get a chance to buy one because it slipped my mind that he was there. But yeah, it's really, he got every little detail. It was really cool. Okay, so number one thing newbies do is they attack this guy. Don't attack that guy. The game will not forgive you for such an action. So let's get started. Let's pump our vitality up to start with. We're gonna go on a few suicide runs here. Just to get the items that we want. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to go down here into New Lorando Ruins. I can't remember what it's called. And we're gonna get the first reinforced Firekeeper Soul. Sorry. We get the Firekeeper Soul, and that will reinforce our first Estus. I usually jump down here and just go for a suicide run. I can pick up the Estoc as well, which is a pretty decent dexterity weapon, at least for the beginning. Once you hit, like, Gaping Dragon, it really isn't that great anymore. It doesn't do enough damage. So we're going down here. I'm going to grab the Estoc right here. Excuse me, sir. There it is. Let's equip that. I think it's a little bit better than the dagger. Oh, can't equip it. What am I missing here? I don't even remember. Okay, so I do need 10 strength to use this. So next time I level up, remember, 10 strength. Alright. Oops. Sorry. Curses are always good. We're gonna need them when we actually get down here. So, this is a cool zone. So it got flooded in an attempt to flood the abyss. And all these lovely characters are the ex-residents of the of this place here. So I'm gonna run up here again, suicide run. I don't expect to live through this. I always try to see what happens, but no. Nope. That's okay. We got our first Estus flask, which we'll turn in. And what else do we want to do? Let's get a real shield. We'll get the Dragon Crest shield too. Dragon Crest that will also kill us. But I like starting off with that shield instead of this little dinky little guy here. To get this shield, we need to... Oh god, I always die there. Ugh, man. We need to go into these ruins one more time and then exit on the right. Go up there and do that. If we're quick enough, we might be able to get the... He's got some other goodies around him. I think it's just soul, so nothing too fantastic. Alright. I wonder if the lights in this place have any significance. I don't know. Okay. Oh, yep. So, we're already using the master key. This is the one door that I like having the master key for. It's the most important door. It gets you to the back of Blighttown over there. Blighttown is just awful. I can already tell it's going to be awful while recording. It's just so framey. Okay. So, run across this bridge here. This dragon is probably going to kill us. But we'll see if we can be quick here. I don't think I've ever gotten all the items, but you can get one or two. So, I can't remember which is which. That's not it. Oh god, that didn't wake him up though. Okay, cool. Oh, he's awake. Got it. Insta-kill. Okay, so we have the Estoc, we have the Firekeeper Soul, we have a real shield, so we're making some progress here. I can't use this either. 10 strength. Okay, so that's going to be a priority. Let's pop some souls, I think. How do I do that? I don't even remember how to do this. Oh, we can use them this way. We'll do the large one. How much do we need to level up? We have enough. So, I think this should be good enough to wield the Estoc and the shield, which is a good start. Now, a fantastic dexterity weapon that you can get right at the start is down here in the graveyard. The Great Scythe is really hard to get, though. I'm not going to get it, I don't think. At least at this moment. Because it you go into an area you really shouldn't be going to, so it feels almost like cheating. If you just kind of run past everything and ignore everything. So, what do we want to do? Do we want to actually start the game? No, we're going to do one more thing. Up here... I hate that guy. We're going to go down the secret passage and grab all that guy's goodies. So this is actually interesting. That guy is very close to these treasure chests. And these treasure chests... Oop. Can't roll. Can't roll. I have to roll. Take off our pants and our gloves. Can I roll? I can't. Okay. So these treasure chests are very interesting. What's here? A cracked red eye orb used to invade other people's worlds. A weapon and a talisman that are directly linked to that, the clerics, I think they're called. Homeward Bone, a way to run away very fast. And finally, a Lloyd's Talisman used to stop people from healing. So, this guy invades other worlds, kills people, and gets away, is what it's implying to me. Is there anything in the graveyard I want? I'm gonna say no. There's one of the best strength weapons in the game is right in the graveyard there. We're gonna skip it. There's also a treasure up there we'll skip. And we hear the bell. So, let's visit this bonfire just to get rid of the skeletons because they will come. We're gonna talk to this guy. He's got some interesting stuff to say.
Well, what do we have here? You must be a new arrival. Let me guess. Fate of the Undead, right?
Right.
Well, you're not the first. But there's no salvation here. You'd have done better to rot in the Undead Asylum. But too late now. Well, since you're here, let me help you out. There are, actually, two Bells of Awakening. One's up above in the Undead Church. The other is far, far, far below, in the ruins at the base of Blighttown.
What's going on with his back?
Link them both, and something happened. Brilliant, right? Not much to go on, but I have a feeling that won't stop you. So, off you go. It is why you came, isn't it? To this accursed land, the undead?
That is correct. Talk to him again. He's got some pretty good stuff to say.
You're practically hollow.
Story-wise and clue-wise.
A hollow could solve quite a bit. What? Restoring your humanity? Well, there are a few ways to go about it. Collect it bit by bit from corpses. Or you can butter up a cleric and get yourself summoned. And the quickest way, although I'd never do it, is to kill a healthy undead and pillage its humanity. Coveting thy neighbor is only human, after all.
Alright, that's enough of that guy. Now, it's very interesting why you're in this state in this game. Why are you a little zombie man? You basically don't die in this game. They made the mechanic of playing over and over again, even if you die, part of the world itself, which is extremely interesting. So instead of dying, the dark sign brings you back to the bonfires, which is linked to Lord Gwyn's soul. You can become more human by using humanity. And you don't die. Instead, you just kind of give up on life. It's almost like Groundhog's Day, where it's just like you just had enough of it, and instead of dying, you go insane, which is a major theme in this game, surprisingly. So let's go back here. Let's grab this. Let's actually start the game. So we're gonna go run up this hill. run into walls, do all sorts of great stuff, and we're going to start. When you start, you want to go up. That's the first thing you do. A lot of people, this is the hub, so a lot of people go the wrong way here, and they get very frustrated because they go to an area they're not supposed to go to. Oh man, I'm really bad. Really bad at this game. Let me try to get better at it through practice. We don't like the S-stock very much. The one thing it does great is you can poke from behind your shield. Ah, you're gonna do that too, huh? You scum, scum. Alright, let's get this guy a little annoying. First, we're going to... Ow. Well. Oh, cool. That took me forever to figure out, but when you see that, it means that someone has kindled a bonfire. What am I doing here? Oops, excuse me. That's what I'm trying to do. How do I kick? I can't seem to kick with this weapon. Huh. Alright, well, I'm gonna stop attempting because I'm gonna die. Alright. Now, I am playing very poorly. Hopefully soon I will stop playing so poorly. Okay, let's go rat up here. Rats can drop humanity, which is very, very useful. It can also poison you, which can kill you. Especially in the beginning of the game, when you have no way to make it go away. So, I'm gonna be poisoned for a while. I'm gonna let it eat my health down a little bit more, and then I'll cure up. Doing really bad. Really bad. I apologize. If you're here to see expert gameplay, you've come to the wrong place. Wow. Oh god. Okay. Let's see if we can power him completely off. Just not my day here. One thing about Dark Souls is if you're just playing like scum like I am right now, turn it off. Go away. Come back to it. You'll be so much better next time you try. I am not going to do that, but I suggest it for other people. Not a good time. I'm gonna die. Yeah, we have to heal now. Alright. Good start. Sorry. Okay, let's get back there real quick. Don't want to waste too much time. No more dying, no more dying. Come on, this is... I'm playing like a scrub. Scrubs play this way. Oops. Probably just get past all these guys. There's my backstab. There's my backstab. Some souls. Am I getting greedy? I'm getting greedy. Alright, backstab him off the cliff. Just backstab. If you're feeling like you're bad at this game, just backstab everything. Boop. Shieldless is probably not the way to go. Backstab. When in doubt, backstab everything. You can get this guy in the air sometimes. Oops. Why can't I? How do you kick in this game? Is it? Nope, that's wrong. Punch. How do you kick? You're gonna need that for a very specific part coming up as in like an hour away. Alright, so let's run up. Let's grab our souls. Let's get moving. I'm not even gonna even mess with that freaking rat up there. Alright, come on, buddy. Come here. Eat scum. eat it. Again, I've given up on parrying or doing anything skill related. Just backstab. It's as easy as it. Easy as it comes. Boop. There's treasure. What does it say? Rolling. Thank you. Alright, let's go in here. I saw someone. Am I in the right place? Not yet. I'll tell you when I get there. Oh, nope, not that way. Yeah, I saw someone kill someone else, an invader, using this dragon. It was extremely impressive. What they did is they went through the woods using the master key at the Firelink Shrine, and basically never went on this path here. They never activated this dragon. Flies away like that, but they got an invader and they basically backed him up into the dragon and the dragon killed him. It was on a YouTuber's top 10 list, I think. His name is Sunlight something or other else, I don't remember. But he's a very good YouTuber, I should definitely link to there if I remember. Oh, high stamina. Excuse me. It's like good old times, it's like PvP. This is the PvP area. Let's pretend I'm fighting a dad bro. I can't remember their names. What are their names? Giant dads. There we go. Alright, so let's block that before we do anything. Alright. Let's rest here. Do I use humanity? Yes. So we're gonna use two humanity here to kindle this bonfire. The reason why we're doing this is I don't need it now, but I'm gonna need it when we fight the Capra Demon. I have trouble with the Capra Demon. And this is the one you have to rest at to get to him. So we will come back to this bonfire. It's not a waste. Humanity is very precious in this game. I don't need humanity for anything really right now that I can think of. Especially on the first boss, you don't need it. Two hand. Starting to come back to me a little. Starting to remember how all these guys work. It's his sword, though. This sword, to be honest, isn't that great. Okay, we are going to go shopping. Ooh, let me get the katana, too. Do I want the katana? I do want the katana. I think we're getting the katana. I don't have to fight this guy, so I don't know if they'll come after me. But we do have to fight this guy, so shield up. Okay. And get him with an R2. Bam. Get wrecked. Okay. These guys following me? No. Alright, this guy.
Now, you seem to have your wits about you. Hmm? Then you are a welcome customer.
Thank you.
I trade for souls. Everything's for sale.
I really want this guy's katana. I really do. Okay. So, order of importance. I need the residence key. Bottomless box. So, 4,000 souls. Let's see if we can get that. I'm gonna pop everything I got. See if I picked up enough to actually buy some of this stuff. Big one. Nah. 2,000. It's not bad. Oh, I'm used to Bloodborne where you need multiple ones. Ooh. How much are these? 200? So, 2, 4. A little short. I'll go up there, kill a dude, and I'll be good. And we can kill the vendor, get the Uchi Katana, and then we have a katana. And it's fantastic. Only because it's a katana. Alright. Go Come here, buddy. I don't like these guys. Because you can't backstab them. That's why I don't like them. You have to use your wits. And a backstab. So, use your wits, get stabbed. Then I do exactly what I said you shouldn't do. Alright, that's gonna be enough. Excuse me. Let's go shopping. I bought you enough souls. Is there anything I want from this guy? Oh, he's got the orange guide stone for a hunt. I'm still short. If I want that as well. It's funny because I've never used it or will never use it. Come on. Ugh. Can I break it? I cannot break it. Backstab. Just backstab everything. The first third of this game, that's all you do. Then you can't backstab things. Then the game gets hard. Alright, yeah, sure. Why not? Oh. Yeah, he only has one. Okay. So, repair box. I definitely want this. Bottomless box. Sure, why not? The repair box is so good because... Blight Town. You get in the middle of Blight Town, your weapon breaks. You're screwed. Okay, so... Decision time. Do I want the Uchi Katana? Yes. Yes, I do.
Gone mad at you? I'll teach you, filthy rat. Yulia! Yulia!
I wonder who Yulia is. It's either the katana itself, or his wife, or a lover, or something. Most people think it's the katana. Maybe named after his wife. He's pretty easy.
Find me, little Yulia.
Sorry, buddy. You have a very good weapon. A very good weapon. That I probably can't use. 14 strength. Okay, so hang on to that. Once we get 14 strength, we will definitely be using it. Problem with the katana is that it breaks. You need to repair it very often. So the repair box was a good idea. I have trouble on these little guys because of shit like that. Alright. Who's next? Oh, come on. Alright. Ooh, I have a banked humanity. I should probably go back to bonfire at the start and kindle that one. Yeah. Alright, got my throwing knives. I think you're supposed to jump off this, if memory serves, for whatever reason. And it just brings you back. Oh, yes, of course. Get your first ranged weapon. Not a good one. One I have used to kill Ornstein and Smo, though. Oh, God. What am I doing? What am I doing? Are they coming down? Yeah. Oof, I don't want to... I gotta get back up the stairs. They're coming from behind. They're coming from everywhere. Oof. Ugh. Do not do well in close quarters. This has never happened to me before. Very close. I didn't see that guy hanging off the edge. Liar. There we are. There's one. And back here is a humanity, I do believe. Yes, a humanity. Which is fun. Why'd he die over there? Who is that guy? Many questions. Let's just run. Oop. I missed this before. So, we're gonna run, and we're just gonna get to the first boss, I think. There's a crappy shield behind that door. I don't need it. Killed all these guys, so we can just start making some progress here. That's a shortcut to the camper demon. And there is a surprise guy right here. But nothing of note. Now here, no, not here. I don't remember what this is. A very good item. Okay, trouble with this trio over here. I think one of them's throws firebombs, there he is. Trying to get some stamina back, having trouble. I'm not gonna get those guys up there. I don't think they're worth it. So this is why we get the resonance key. In here is a very important item. Kind of your boss killer item, but please note coming back here activates that guy right there, so he's gonna waddle on up and we're gonna have to deal with him, but he's gonna come very slowly, so I'm gonna jump up here and take out this archer before he gets here. Praise the sun. Okay, shield up, because I don't know where he is. Shoot. I was hoping to not fight him in here. I was able to get out. Thanks, buddy. Come on, get out of there. Come on, get out of there. There you go. Good guy. Alright. I do not like fighting these guys. Come on, your corner. Do something. There's a treasure up there. I think it's nothing I want. Okay, let's activate these guys. Two at a time. I don't care. Ouch. Nope. That's what happens. You get too aggressive and you pay for it. I hope I have enough to kill the first boss. That's gonna be embarrassing. Man, three left. If I wasn't recording this, I would run back. Alright, and try to heal up before I did this. But I am recording, so careful of this trap. This will kill you. This guy, let's see if we can get a quick backstab. Didn't get it. Whew. Thanks, guy. Someone kindled a bonfire. Okay, we're gonna run up here. Four for this guy. I think that's enough to kill him. I think I should be okay. Especially if I pop some of the good items. So in here is a lizard, which is going to be very hard to kill with such a weak weapon. Don't really need it, but I mostly don't want to come back for it. Got him. Two large Titanite shards. That will be very useful when we get there. Here's the boss. What you want to do on this guy is you want to go up this ladder. This is a very interesting boss because he forces you... He doesn't force you, but if you were paying attention on the first boss, you can kill this guy much, much easier if you use what you learned, basically. Something that I did not think of until I saw a Let's Play of someone doing it, but really fantastic game design on this guy. That's how you slide. Alright, here we go. First boss. Let's not activate him yet. Let's get some fire bombs going. I'm gonna try my best not to use them, but if shit hits the fan, then I will use them. I will be using the gold pine resin, though. I like to use these on the first couple bosses. They definitely help out. So, Taurus Demon pops up. The first thing you want to do is run back to this ladder up here. You have enough time to do this, but he's going to not wait around like the first boss did. So you want to use your gold pine resin, you want to two-hand it, and you want to go. And you can just do a lot of damage. Looks like a goat, man. Excuse me. Yeah, I should do it. Keep your stamina up, though. Stamina's very important. Rolls. He didn't get touched. Not even touched. very cool. Okay, now the tricky part. You want to get to the next bonfire, but to get there, you're going to have to get past a very fun obstacle. Which is this bridge. But first, we're going to meet the best character in the entire game, our good friend Solaire.
Ah, hello. You don't look hollow, far from it. I am Solaire of Astora, an adherent of the Lord of Sunlight. Now that I am undead, I have come to this great land, the birthplace of Lord Gwyn, to seek my very own son. Do you find that strange? Well, you should. No need to hide your reaction. I get that look all the time.
You want to keep talking to him?
Oh, aha. So I didn't scare you. I have a proposition, if you have a moment.
I do.
Well, yes. Quite understand. Not to worry. I was in the wrong.
Always say yes. There's only one time you say no in this game.
Hello? Then...
Yes.
The way I see it, our fates appear to be intertwined. In a land brimming with hollows, could that really be mere chance? So what do you say? Why not help one another on this lonely journey?
Yes.
It pleases me greatly. Well then, take this.
Thank you very much, Solaire. Oh, missed that last part. It is theorized that Solaire... It could also be part of the prophecy, the one to bring balance to the lords of whatever's. He is theorized to be the son of Gwyn. But, you know, who knows? Alright. So we unlocked a shortcut right here. We're gonna rest at this bonfire that we have kindled. It's like I planned it or something. And I think we're gonna call it for today. So I think that's gonna be the end of my first Let's Play. And I'll continue tomorrow. Thank you very much, everyone. Very fun.